Yo, what's going on, good people? It's your boy Eric Taylor, Big E Astrology. G. Oh my gosh, the sun feels so good today. Well, it's fitting because I'm back doing my Chiron sign series, and this is Chiron in Sagittarius, the Archer, the mutable fire sign. Associated with the ninth house. So that's where the sun is in its planetary joy, in the ninth house. So we're gonna break down Chiron, the wounded healer, Sagittarius, the archer. And I'll give you some famous people, but like always, I hate to be redundant, but like I say and I tell you, I think you're famous. You're freaking dope. And you gotta believe it. Not just me saying it, you gotta believe it for yourself, own that. Right? No mistakes. God makes no mistakes. He made all of us complex and unique and dope. You know what I'm saying? So, Chiron. Well, the Greek mythology, Chiron was a centaur, right? We're talking about, Ophelia and Zeus, all this stuff, and then Apollo, and anyway, so... What you need to know is that Chiron became or was immortal and was an amazing healer. He was rejected first by his mother because how he looked. Okay? That first initial wound can come while you're in the womb or shortly right after birth. And then the second Chiron wound, and for Chiron, he got wounded. So either it was something with Hercules or he shot himself by accident. But Chiron had this wound and could not heal himself, even though he was this great healer. And so he wanted to become mortal and then ascended to create the Sagittarius constellation and is in between Saturn and Uranus, right? The restrictions and fears and anxiety of the Saturn and the liberation and freedom, right, of Uranus. Okay, Chiron, the wounded healer, is an emotional, physical, or spiritual wound that you will see in the birth chart, and it's going to be at the degree point in Sagittarius, in the house that it's in your chart. It could be the first, the fourth, the sixth, the eighth, the ninth, the 11th, okay, wherever. So let's say if it's 13 degrees, the wound can be around 13 years old. It's 25. It could be at 25 years old. But sometimes you can add the numbers together. So 25 could be a seven-year-old, right? 17 could be the eight-year-old. Sometimes you will not remember. So it could be like 3, 4, 5 years old. So you gotta, I've done this with many clients. So I gotta ask, go ask mom, ask dad. But sometimes you know exactly what happened. Even sometimes 6, 7, 8, 9 years old, okay? And you're gonna see the wound through the lens of Sagittarius energy, which I'm about to explain, or the house. Seventh house, it could be through marriage, right? Fifth house, through high school, college, creativity, you know, things like that when you were young. Third house, with you and your siblings, friends, your neighborhood, your cousins, school, elementary school. You get it? So, Sagittarius the Archer, mutable fire sign, the final fire sign. Sagittarius is about your beliefs, your philosophy, your wisdom, your higher learning. It's expansion, right? It's ruled by Jupiter. It's fortune, luck, your optimistic nature. It's blunt and sometimes arrogant and likes to zoom out and see the big picture. It's the teacher, the wisdom seeker, the preacher. It's like exploring. The bachelor, bachelorette sign is Sagittarius, but it loves freedom, keyword freedom, and loves to travel and explore, okay? Sagittarius is associated with the hips and thighs, right? Your wisdom, philosophies, beliefs, athletic ability, okay? So we're gonna blend the Chiron with the Sag, but first, some famous people. So RIP first, Robin Williams. Then you got Samuel L. Jackson, Stevie Wonder, Lionel Richie, Bill Murray, Zion Williamson. I think, you know, some of these guys are all the same age. I think Ja Morant, Zion Williamson, RJ Barrett, Willow Smith. Okay. So when you've got, because this is about you, forget Zion. What's up, Zion? But if you have this wound, this is usually going to be, you look at the age for the, you find the degree point. But this energy antenna is what Chiron is. It's where you have these sensitivities. And this physical, emotional, or spiritual wound can be around learning, around sharing your beliefs and philosophies. Sagittarius is the law, religion. It could be around being forced to go to church or even being abused sexually in church or the Catholic nuns disciplining you, right? This can be around your freedom and wanting to explore or share your optimistic viewpoints. Somebody being pessimistic or strict on you and telling you, oh, you can't do this and you'll never go to college and you'll never be this, you'll never be that. Or trying to control you, manipulate, brainwash you to believe whatever they believe. The wound will come through those themes and that lens. And a lot of times you've got to find out how to heal your inner child and look at that degree point and figure out, well, you know what? Maybe I don't feel fortunate or lucky. My life has always been, you know, kicking me in the butt, or, you know, I never had the opportunity to go on a vacation or travel, or I didn't have enough money to go to college, or I went to a very poor high school where we didn't even have good books. Yeah, it can create that emotional wound. That physical wound could come through, you know, maybe the Catholic Church, being disciplined or spanked, or being forced to go to church or the religion. You know, maybe you believed in the Easter Bunny and you know, people made you feel bad for believing that, or, you know, whatever it could be. But a lot of times you're going to see that that degree point will tell you exactly what that wound is dealing with. And that your thoughts, your wisdom, your knowledge, your learning was hindered. It created a wound. Your freedom to think or travel, your freedom to believe what you wanted, to be fortunate and lucky and optimistic, was taken away from you, creating this physical, emotional, or spiritual wound, right? Maybe you wanted to go to a Catholic school, and your parents couldn't afford it, you know? Maybe you were in public school and then you were made to go to Catholic school and wear the uniform and you hated it and you got beat up or bullied there. Or maybe you were the only kid in your school that was Muslim and you were in an area that was all Catholic or Christian. There's a lot of ways that this wound can play out that can make you feel less than, not intelligent, not free to believe or think what you want. So the way to really heal this wound is to help others to find their freedom, to find knowledge, to share their beliefs and philosophies, to be optimistic, to have fun, to dream about flying and traveling across the world and going to foreign lands and foreign countries and learning about different cultures, you know, and to know that it's okay to dream, it's okay to wander, to go on adventures. Because when you can help others to do the things that you couldn't do, that's how you activate the healing of this wound. And in turn, when you do that, then you can also heal yourself. it's great when you get to explore and travel and see the world or read books or learn new things or new ways of believing in God or different philosophies or faith. Reading about Socrates and Plato, or, you know, reading about ancient Kemet, or, you know, Babylon, or other religions, or other, you know, metaphysical knowledge. To have an open mind, to gain wisdom, new perspectives. You know, sometimes this wound could be that you were forced to only think one way. You were controlled and manipulated. The power over under dynamic, you know? You know, and I can't point out specific things, but maybe there was this, you know, these issues went through for Lionel Richie or Bill Murray or Samuel L. Jackson, Robin Williams, Willow, Zion. But the main thing is, when you find out that wound, the best advice I can give you, and I do this with all my clients, is that you have to write letters to your younger self, usually from ages 8 to 18. 3 negative memories, 3 positive memories. But it can also start, if you remember, at the degree point. Let's say your Chiron wound is at 6 or 7 degrees in Sagittarius. And let's say your parents got divorced and it's in the 7th house. And you and your mom moved away and you never got to see your dad. But maybe once a year, and then that stopped after a year or two. That could create that wound. Chiron, Sagittarius, 7 degrees, 7th house. That could be the exact story for you. And so then you've got to try to heal the relationship, one, maybe with your father, but then make sure when you're married that you show a healthy relationship and partnership and marriage for your children, and then try to, you know, emulate and really instill a healthy marriage and relationship for them. Does that make sense? So, you know, Sagittarius, the archer, the centaur, half horse, half man, you know, this is definitely a spirit of freedom, of travel, being fortunate and optimistic and sharing your beliefs and ideas. And, you know, I think a lot of times, a lot of people are recovering from how they were raised and the religious law that was put on them. And I'm not saying religion is bad. All right? I'm a Christian, I love Jesus. But sometimes people manipulate, oppress, or control you through the law of religion. Or you had a parent that was like a cop or a detective and they were abusive. See, this is, could be the emotional physical. So this is why you have to really look at this Chiron wound and learn how to work with it, okay? And after I finish this service, I mean, the whole series, I'll be offering just a mini Chiron reading. Not the full birth chart, but just if you want to work on the Chiron wound. And it will be, you know, probably less than $50. And I'll announce it soon in a week or two, you know, maybe April 1st. But I really want to help people to heal the Chiron wound, because it's important. And when you learn to help others, in turn, you're helping yourself. All right, Chiron and Sagittarius. Dream big. Explore the world. Be fortunate and optimistic and lucky. Have a big perspective. Be open to all religions and cultures and philosophies and beliefs. Learn, expand your mind. Go to college. Go to classes online. Go get your master's, PhD. You got this, Chiron and Sag, okay? Your beliefs, your philosophies, your ideas, your faith, it matters. You matter. Okay? So holler at your boy. I got you. BigE Astrology. Email me. You want to book a chart. Still Pisces season, right? We're in March of 2023. My Pisces birth chart sale ends March 20th. You email me, taylor2coaching@gmail.com. You can book a reading. I have my audio chart readings, only $75. And for International Women's Day and Women's History Month, I have a service breaking down the 5 D's to help a woman find her purpose and reach and achieve her goals through the lens of astrology, right? You have to define, develop, discipline, dreams, and destiny. So that's the sun sign, Mercury, Saturn, Jupiter, and Neptune in the North Node. It's a great birth chart reading. Only $90 until March 31st, just for the ladies. And if people really like it, I'll open it up for everybody in April and make it a permanent service. But you email me. You can do an audio chart or live birth chart reading over Zoom, focusing on those planets and the houses and those 5 D's. Because that's where we're headed, to the 5D, leaving the 3D behind. Leave the worries and stress and fear and anxiety behind. That's lower vibration. We're ascending. So ascend with me, ladies, at taylor2coaching@gmail.com. All right. Bye, Chiron and Sag. Doses. We're going to heal these wounds. Get your freedom and travel and explore and learn and share your wisdom. All right. Later, Chiron and Sagittarius. Peace. BigE Astrology.